people. Hello everyone. How you guys doing? How you doing there? How you doing at home? How you doing in the office? Hope you're already going out. I told you things was going to get better. Now it's getting better. Hope you're already doing sightseeing and you're already leaving the house. You're seeing things, you know, gradually in your country, in your city. Well, I've not stepped outside yet. I'm still getting ready, but hopefully by next week I should be out. So you're welcome to my channel, and if you are here for the first time, I am Favor Napoleon. Good to see you here. And if you are already a subscriber, and thank you for always tuning to my channel. On today's episode, we're going to have an interesting time, and I'm going to be talking about matters of the heart. You know, when all these kind of matters comes on, why women, me included, are so emotional, and when men are the way they are, you know, when a woman behaves in a certain kind of way and a man behaves in a certain kind of way, loud and saying it all out, you know, I always keep it real. So I'm going to go in for a short break now. Please don't go anywhere. I'll be right back after the short break. You are welcome back to my channel. So back to the matter of the day. You know, a woman responds to the things around her because of the way she's wired, and a man does the same too because of the way he's wired. A man is designed in a specific way, while the woman is also designed in a specific way. So when a woman receives an information, when she receives an information around her, when things comes, the things that happens around her, a woman processes it mentally and emotionally at the same time. Why? Because a woman is a feeler. You know, when we feel things, we like feeling, you know. So a woman is a feeler. So when she receives this information, she processes it and assess it mentally and emotionally. So that's why we respond the way we do. The man is not like that. The way he responds to the world around him, when things happen around him, the man processes it logically, as in a man is a logic thinker. So the man thinks about it, processes what he happens around him, and he gets information from it. But the woman doesn't do that. She responds to her situation emotionally. You see the way I'm demonstrating it. So that's we didn't make it that way. It just happens that way. The way she reacts to the world around her, maybe when somebody passes her, looks at her, a woman responds to that kind of thing emotionally. Oh, look at the way this person is looking at me. Look at the way this person is seeing me. You know, she read meanings through her emotions to those things. But for a man, it's not like that. A man is a thinker. For example, maybe there's a couple. They got an information, they got home and saw their house got burnt. The first response of the woman is that she will be emotional. Is it that she collapsed, or is it that she's crying, or is it that she just burst into tears, or maybe she's running, people are trying to hold her, she's just, you know, that's the first reaction of a woman to that kind of incident. But with a man, he will start running. He will start acting the way the woman does. What he will do is, the first thing that comes to his mind, he start thinking, where can I take my family to now? What can I do next? What can I do? Who should I call? You know, that's the first thing immediately that will come to a man. Why? Because of the way the man is wired. But the woman is not wired that way. The woman is not designed that way. So the first thing that comes to our mind is we respond to situation from our own emotional way, emotionally, because we are feelers. But men are thinkers. They are logical in their thinking. What a man lacks, the woman might have. That is why they are supposed to complement each other. That's why husband and wife are supposed to complement each other. That's why two people in a relationship are supposed to complement each other, because what one has, the other might not have. So that's where the complement comes in. That's where the balancing comes in. That doesn't mean that the man does not use his emotions, or the woman doesn't use her logic. Or it just simply means that they have a specific way of responding to the world around them. They have a specific way of reacting. The man have his emotions, but the woman always have her emotions with her all the time. The emotion day all the time. So that's the way she responds So the both of them, both the woman has a lot, has a logic, the man too does, has his emotions, but they just have a specific way of responding to things. They just have a specific way of responding to situations and things around them. No one gender can look at the world in the same perspective. That is why the woman and the man perspective is so important. Just for example, when a situation happens, for instance, to we women, when something, maybe we are hurt by our husband, our boyfriend, whoever we're in relationship with, you know, our fiance, our, you know, whoever we are in relationship with, you know, when we are hurt, when a woman is hurt, she respond emotionally immediately. She might burst into tears, you know, because the man is a thinker. When a man thinks, what he brings out is information. A man can give you an information, but when the woman processes it, she processes that information emotionally because she's a feeler. Okay, then maybe she start crying. When she start crying, not necessarily that the man is not hurt by her tears or he's not feeling the fact that his feeling is there. Not that he's not feeling the fact that the woman is crying or all that, because the woman's feeling is with her all the time. So not that he's not feeling what the woman is, he's not feeling the tears that the woman is bringing out. He wants information. He wants to know, honey, sweetheart, honey pie, honey boo, what is the problem? What can I do to fix this? So that is what a man is concerned about. He wants information because he's a thinker. Just tell me what I can do to fix it. Just tell me what I can do to stop these tears. So he will not respond emotionally to her. He will demand information from her to change things because he is a thinker and he's a logical thinker. All he needs is an information, and all he gives is an information. He thinks and he gives information. So that's what we'll be looking at for. What can I do to help? Can you tell me what to do to stop these tears? So that's the way a man will respond. If you tell a man, guy, you look ugly, you know, a man might just respond to the person, you look ugly too. You know, you look ugly too. But you tell a woman that kind of thing, what she will do is 80% of women might not respond. You know, maybe there are some women, 20%, I will just tell them back the way it is. But 80% of women might not necessarily respond to that person. What they will do, they will keep they'll respond to it emotionally. And that saying that the person is ugly might be in the woman's heart as long as she lives. So that's how women respond to things. It's just like the husband telling his wife, this cloth you are wearing, don't you think it's too tight? Wear something else. She might not just receive it like that. You know, she might receive it, oh, he's not telling me I'm fat. You know, because she's an emotional being, because she's a feeler. Just for example, maybe a lady, she cooks a meal for her husband, her fiance, you know. And at the end of the day, the man comes out and say, this food is so salty. And maybe at the end of the day, maybe in the evening, you guys went for a dinner or went to someone's, a friend's house, and you got there, and your husband has said, or the fiance says, this food is delicious. You know, the woman will respond to it emotionally. She will respond to it because she's a feeler. But the man gives information because he gives information because of the way he thinks. So the woman might not understand that this man is just giving out and dishing out information, you know. So because of the way the woman is, she will emotionalize. Is there any word like that? I don't know. She will just emotionalize everything. Men respond to things and situations because of the way they think. Just for example, a woman might have planned that, maybe probably she even planned it with her husband, that they've not spent time together, they're going to spend nice time together that evening. So the woman go all way, she prepared sweet things. You know how we do it now. Sweet 90, that red dress, you know, that you want to have a nice and a sweet time with your man tonight. She gets all the flowers, all the wine with the dark lights and everything, prepare a sweet meal because they don't want to go out, so they just had plans because of the time, they want to do it in the house. So she sweet perfume, that something must happen this night, you know those kind of stuff. So but at the end of the day, she has already made her plan, she has already prepared everything. waiting for the man to come home, you know, why she would just, she has imagined everything in her mind. You know how we do these things emotionally. Because we are feelers. So she's waiting for a man, and the man just eventually comes on and comes in, and get, and she opens the door trying to hug the man, hugging, and with his laugh, like, honey, honey, you know, I want to watch the football. You know, the man just responds, I want to watch the football right now. Can you please bring my meal? I want to sit in front of the TV and watch while eating. Or probably I want to watch the news or the wrestling or whatever. The man just communicates it to his wife like that. And the woman will be deeply hurt. Or will not be hurt by that kind of situations, you know. So, the woman will be deeply hurt. Why? Because she's a feeler. She's a feeler, she's emotional. But the man goes straight to the TV and the woman becomes angry. The man perspective of telling the woman to bring the food to the room, to the living room or to the bedroom just to watch in front of the TV might not necessarily be just to hurt the wife. His perspective about it is just because of the way he's thinking, because of the way he's processing things. But because the woman doesn't understand, she misunderstands the man. She will interpret it wrongly. Men give information because of the way they think. But women are emotional and they are feelers because of the way we understand and process things. The difference between a man and a woman is meant to be a help to them, not an hindrance at all. It's not supposed to be an hindrance. It's supposed to be an advantage to both of them. That's why the difference is so unique. Differences in relationship is a yes, yes. Men, guys, you need to know that before you tell a woman anything, you need to consider her. You need to think about what you want to say. You need to know how you're going to process it, because women are emotional. You have to understand our emotions and our feeling. You know, you want to say the right thing. You don't just spill it out the way it is. You look for a better way to say it. You have to consider the woman that she is a feeler. She's made that way. You cannot change it, and you cannot apologize for that, for the way she's made, because that is the way a woman is made. So that is the way a woman is wired. That is the way a woman is designed. So when men, you want to speak to your wife or your spouse or your girlfriend or your fiancé, you have to consider her. You have to know that, oh, she's an emotional feeler. She's a feeler. So you put things in a way that it will suit her, so that she's not hot at the end of the day. And then women, we have to put our emotion too in place. We have to be able to check our emotion, to understand that men are, they are thinkers. They give information, so they might tell you the way it is too. So you, it doesn't mean they don't love you. It doesn't mean they don't care about you. They are just saying it the way they process these things. They are just saying it the way they think. So we too have to have the balance. We have to know how to put all these things in place. And I've come to the end of this episode today. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Hope you were able to understand why men behave the way they do. Not that they don't love you. They do, girl. They do. And women, you have to also understand that they love us. You know, it's just the way they process these things. And it's just the way they say it out. They give information because they are logical thinkers. And thank you for tuning to my channel. Hope you have a nice time. Let me know what you think about this topic. Let me know about what you think about this matters of the heart. You know, this matter used to, I would have tagged it gengen, you know. And if you like this episode, please don't forget to press the like button. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I really had fun while sharing. I hope you feel the same way too. So please, let's hear from you. I like being in the comment section. And promise me you're going to stay happy. See you in the next episode. See you on Tuesday. Bye.